two attacks or three he had been. Well, first he would kind of act like he was sick in his stomach, and if he had eaten anything, he probably would lose it. And his eyes would lose their focus. You could see that he would look at you but wouldn't see you. And he couldn't hear distinctly, and a lot of times he would grab at the door or something, and when he did, I knew he'd be about to pass out or something, and I would lead him to the bed and put him on the bed.
Have you seen him?
At the time I saw him, about, it was around 8 or 8:30, the evening of February 17th, he was totally irrational and incoherent, and members of his family just had to stand right beside him and hold him on the bed. I don't believe he recognized me, and it didn't seem to me that he recognized any other members of his family.
Seemed to be in a state of shock. He was cold and clammy, and we had some aromatic spirits in the morning, so we gave him some of them to smell, and he revived some. And he was able to mumble, and he finally revived after several minutes. It was about a half hour when he finally.
George Bledsoe.
You're the defendant in this case, are you, George?
Yes.
Now, how old are you, please?
33.
Are you married?
You've had for many, many years periods of loss of consciousness, brief amnesic periods, I would call them, characterized by his blacking out, either with accompanied by or not accompanied by unconsciousness, but at least lapses of memory. He's had four of these blackouts that I know of, that is, situations that he's described to me.
Jump up.
Can you say anything?
I said, this is Bledsoe, both of them freeze. You won't get hurt.
What is it?
They started at me. I had the hammer raised up over his head, and just had the fire raised up. That time, I didn't
of Yost's head looked like a gun. When they wouldn't stop, I stopped firing.
You know how many steps he took for you?
Do you recall the circumstances of his coming into your shop?
Very well.
Did you tell this court and this jury what those circumstances were?
He entered the codes and gave us his tag number and said it was sufficient, suspicious car